McCormack telling our Ali Trost Martin before the fight, my mind is now bulletproof. That will be put to the test here because Valesca Machado staggers her with a right hand right out of the gate. Oftentimes we've seen Machado collecting data early on in the fight, but not this time. Inflicting damage right out of the gate. McCormack with a counter on the left hand.
Yeah, nice left hand there. McCormack has quite a bit of power, as we saw in her debut in Invicta.
She really staggered Mazar early in that fight with a big left hand. Some damage on the nose of Danni McCormack.
McCormack's reading some of those hooks. She's reading some of those hits that she can get on the exit. Machado doing a really good job of reading that takedown entry of McCormack. You know, a lot of beautiful.
Knockdown. Machado.
Big shots there from the Brazilian.
McCormack's in trouble right now.
And McCormack's in full guard. Bettina Black continues to throw hands.
Wow.
She said she wanted a finish tonight, and she is hunting hard for one.
Absolutely relentless. Oh, she's got the back.
Continuing to hit, drawing blood from the challenger, and still staying so relaxed as she ties up on her back.
She's looking for that rear naked choke there. McCormack doing a really good job of fighting the hands, not allowing Machado to get that arm underneath the neck. But she's got to address that body triangle. She's not going to be able to do much if she can't get rid of that lock.
Yeah, she needs to adjust her position, roll to the other side, possibly look for a way to put pressure. Big shots there. And already the triangle has been adjusted. McCormack is looking to dig out that leg. Triangle's back on, and now Machado is on the back.
And Machado's been showing everything through this first round. A couple of big knockdowns with the right hand.
Oh, nicely done there from McCormack, spinning in. Now she has the head. Good chance to knee here, an elbow, but Machado frees her head, still tied up.
Beautiful knee by Machado.
Well, whatever the last fight was lacking in action has been made up for quickly here in round number one of the main event.
And that was well read by McCormack, tying up underneath off of Machado's strike. The Brazilian stays very relaxed up against the fence.
And McCormack with the double unders here, we'll see if she's able to utilize that outside leg reap to her advantage. But Machado staying really patient here, very, very balanced, very controlled in her defense in this position.
McCormack's tied her knees together. She can get some leverage there. Not quite enough.
30 seconds remaining in round number one. Machado's wearing some of the blood from McCormack's face on her own face right now.
Takedown attempt from McCormack. She's tied up. Machado looking for inside control now with her left hand.
So 10 seconds left in round number one. Machado with a couple of big knockdowns on McCormack as round number one comes to a close. Tina Black Machado definitely looked like the champ in round number one. Here we go into round number two. And Megan, it'll be interesting to see the way Danni McCormack recovers from that round and adjusts if she can.
Exactly, and she's looking to pressure. She's looking to pressure. She's looking to push the pace. I think she's having a little bit of an issue with the range right now. She hasn't found her range yet, whereas Machado has. And when we spoke with McCormack earlier this week, she's like, I do my best work when I put my opponent on the ground. She hasn't been able to do that yet.
Jules, that straight right hand from Machado a couple of different times in the first round is what did the damage. She's got to be careful about that.
She absolutely has to be careful about that, and also not being slow with the takedowns. She's got to set up those takedowns, put something in front of it. But McCormack told us, you know, she wants to make this an ugly close fight. She wants to get in there. She wants to make the Brazilian work on the inside especially, and she has been successful in getting some of these exchanges off.
She caught a left hand on Machado there on the exit.
Yeah, and one thing I would like McCormack to adjust a little bit is her head is very stationary, and that, I think, is where Machado was able to capitalize on, because the target is there and it's never moving, and particularly with the open stance, it's going to be easier for Machado to hit that right hand and keep herself safely, defensively sound as well.
And of course, when you're having a left-handed lead versus a right-handed lead, it all becomes about that placement of the front foot. And both of them are working to outpace each other there. Back up against the cage here, McCormack grinding her head into the Brazilian, trying to off-balance her. And the best ways to off-balance here is to pull the line of the neck off the line of the hips, right? You want to engage the spine at an angle so they don't have strength underneath it. And McCormack is definitely attempting to do that here. Machado staying very calm. Spinning out, but her chin is up, and that can be dangerous.
McCormack doing a really good job of utilizing her head there to help her with her control in this position. Let's see if she can capitalize off this and take Machado to the ground.
Failed attempt there, but McCormack seems to at least calm the waters a little bit, because the way it was starting the first couple of minutes of round number one, that was not sustainable for her.
No, and she's adjusted. She's closed the range now. You can't be all the way out with Machado. She will pick you apart from range. She is technically very, very good with her striking. So now she's making it a grinding, grappling, wrestling fight, which favors McCormack, because she knows that she can keep this up for 25 minutes. Now, Machado might defensively be sound, and it might be hard to take her down, but in these positions, she's not winning.
And it's exhausting.
Yes, exactly. Can she keep up this defense for 25 minutes?
Ooh, nice elbow there from a brace from Machado. She braced her left arm across the neck and threw an up elbow. That was beautiful.
And Jules, you said maybe sometimes you got to taste your own blood. Machado's tasting some of McCormack's blood right now, too, because of the way she was grinding up against the cage there. Well, there's a left hand from Tina Black Machado.
We definitely are seeing more intensity from Machado here. Danni McCormack is doing what she needs to do. She's making this a grind.
She had to change this fight, and change it she has done.
You know what's funny is, change the fight, yeah, but this was the fight she wanted, so maybe she just had to find her.
Had
fight
to get there. Yeah,
yeah, find her place. And look at the way Machado is bracing on the face like that before she was able to create space right there and then throw the upward angle elbow from her other hand. Doesn't do that there. When you look at this kind of match between these two fighters, you know the ugly fight is gonna favor the person who is, I would say McCormack's a striker, but she definitely views herself more as a ground fighter, and the ugly fight definitely favors her, making it ugly, making it grinding. I enjoy that. That always worked for me. Well, maybe 13 times it didn't, but
who's counting? Less than 10 seconds left in round number two.
Nice right jab landed from McCormack. Ooh.
Now we go to round number three. Remember, this is the championship bout, so we've got five rounds of action. And according to the scores, the judges, it's dead even. So Danni McCormack steadied the ship after that first round, and now she's right back in this thing.
And I'm not a fan of that takedown entry. Like, that's a good way to get cracked. But so far, Machado really hasn't made her pay for it.
You know, you can hear McCormack's cornerman, John Kavanagh, you know, imploring her not to reach for that takedown. Stop reaching, set that up, because it's going to be a bad time if she gets caught in that in-between and she's not defensively sound.
There's a big right hand from Tina Black.
McCormack tenacious on that takedown, though. This is where she wants this fight to be. You know, doing a good job of utilizing that head position, controlling with the underhook.
And the way, yeah, Tina Black is snaking her hips side to side like that is giving her more of an opening, more of a way to use the cage to her advantage when her back is against it, to use it as a tool for movement.
And I do like how she's having a little bit more urgency to get her back off the cage, because she knows she cannot sit there for too long. Otherwise, she's going to give up rounds.
Give up rounds and give up air.
It's a good combination
Beautiful.
That time for McCormack.
I was admiring it too. Nate, I didn't mean to speak over you. But again, there's that big motion takedown. Oh, beautiful elbows from the Brazilian right there and a right hand to follow it.
There seems to be a lot of swelling under the eyes of McCormack, which could not, it could be detrimental to her as the fight goes on if her eyes start to close up.
And she does another reaching takedown attempt, puts Tina Black up against the fence once more.
We're halfway through this fight, guys, and the fitness component will continue to become a bigger issue. Here at Elevation, it bears repeating, as these two athletes are trying to figure out, you know, which person's going to get to dictate the terms.
I just think, I love how mean Danni McCormack is as a fighter. She uses everything to her disposal, or at her disposal, just grinding that head in there, grabbing, reaching, punching, following the clinch with as many strikes or whatever strikes she can pull off.
Absolutely relentless.
And Megan, to your point, she seems to be the one wearing all the damage so far, but that doesn't necessarily tell the whole story.
No, and big right hand by Machado there. And like, McCormack needs to get her head off the satellite. That is why she's getting hit so consistently with that right hand. It's stationary, it's a stationary target. So she needs to adjust that going forward in this fight.
Yeah, most of those right hands are right down the middle, aren't they?
Right down the middle, and that is where Machado does her best work, is when she's able to utilize the full capacity of her range.
Oh, nice elbow from McCormack.
Right in front of us. There's another right hand right down the middle.
And that nose is busted. Danni McCormack has a very broken nose from what I can see.
Back against the cage again. Under a minute left in round number three. Get the sense McCormack is going to find a way to come out on top here. She's got to find a way to avoid those straight right hands. Part of the way she's done it is just get it up against the cage. But in this setting right here, she's got to be careful.
And I feel like Machado is doing a much better job of not allowing McCormack to keep her on the cage longer like she did in the second round.
10 seconds left in the third round.
Yeah.
My mind is bulletproof. Her mental strength really cannot be called into question the way she survived these first three rounds, and it's close. Danni McCormack ahead on two of the judges' scorecards after these first three rounds. So clearly, according to two of the judges, at least all that damage is not telling the whole story. That was a left hand from McCormack and a counter from Tita Black Machado.
Big left hand.
Wow.
McCormack landing some shots.
And she, again, I'm going to use what you said, wearing her down a little bit, wearing on her, making her slow down and just engage where
Big
McCormack wants her to engage.
She's making Machado wear her weight, mm-hmm. which is exhausting, over 25 minutes.
Mm-hmm. One of the things I've noticed, guys, from McCormack on those separations, she's getting a good left hand in there. A lot of times on the exit.
Yeah,
is McCormack.
She's also catching one a couple of times. She's catching a right hand, but she just doesn't seem to care. She isn't moving her head like you said, Megan. Takedown attempt there from Machado leading to a nice knee. But again, McCormack just slugging it out.
And she seems to be, she might not be the first to start the exchange, but she's the last, which is putting a stamp on the exchange between the two.
I love fighting.
But Machado still moving, mm-hmm. still landing that right hand, still having success. You know, she just needs to make a few adjustments to stop this right here. Is McCormack putting her back on the cage, because that is what is racking up that control time for McCormack.
It is. It's not that she's not, like you said, showing good defensive work on the cage, but she's getting put there. Oh,
left hand from McCormack
shot.
And then a body shot.
Machado looking for a trip, not getting it. McCormack staying tight on her like a burr. Oh, love those exit elbows, but I do think she needs to get her foot off the brake a little bit.
Just passed halfway through round number four. Back against the cage again.
And while we say, you know, Machado needs to...
Wow.
Oh, beautiful there.
McCormack is able to finally drag her to the ground. Machado's back up, and McCormack delivers damage.
Is she wearing... Are you seeing some signs that Tita Black is wearing down a little bit?
Oh, well, her volume isn't there. And McCormack is able to land a lot more with these combinations. The speed of Machado has slowed down significantly from that first round, and McCormack is able to have a lot more success in the striking now that Machado's a little bit more lethargic. She's weared her weight and she's exhausted now that we're, you know, almost 20 minutes into this fight.
And that's one of the beautiful takedown. Relentless on her shorts, relentless in her spirit is Danni McCormack. And I will say this, she has been able to land shots. One of Tita Black's greatest strengths is her ability to hit and not get hit back as much. She's always moving her head. McCormack just refuses to accept that.
Because she doesn't allow Machado to create space. She is walking her down. She is pressuring her. She is not allowing her to fight pretty.
Mm-hmm. Oh. Machado looking for a heel hook on the Irish fighter now. McCormack countering, trying to take the foot off the hip. She's very patient here, and she can end up in top position. But a heel hook, you know, it hurts. Soda's getting punched in the face, though.
And McCormack's sinking a couple of shots in there. As with 30 seconds left in the fourth round.
And you can see the angle of Danny's knee. She's not quite in danger yet.
I think her knee is out now.
Mm-hmm.
If she's able to step over, she's
going
to be in a much safer position.
Oh,
and then gets a right hand and another right hand.
Erin Gobra, amazing.
McCormack raining down blows on the champ. And we go to round number five with the strawweight title on the line at Invicta FC 52. Breaking barriers, building legends. That's what it's about, and here we go.
Got to go back to the metaphors. She's not playing chess, she's playing rugby.
And McCormack is 5 minutes away from making double history tonight.
On her birthday, no less. And they're on the ground again.
Two days away from St. Patrick's Day. You could not have asked for a better setup.
So, Tina Black tried to negate the takedown attempt with a whizzer, but Danni McCormack staying on her, staying tight. Whoa, and delivering knees on the way up.
Megan's got some blood splattered on her headset. That's okay, that's part of the deal.
That's the luck of the Irish.
At least it's not on the nice white top that you're wearing there, Megan.
The athletes are too kind.
But it is, this has been a main event worthy of a main event. Hey, Tina Black is not out of this thing.
Absolutely not.
Oh,
huge takedown by McCormack though.
That was so sophisticated, you guys. She was pushing and grinding one angle, hit the corner, and absolutely went over the other side. I mean, it's dragging somebody down with grace.
Tina Black doing a really good job of getting back to her feet, though. She's looking to dig for her own underhook, but McCormack's got those double unders and is just relentless on that control and pressure.
Now with the open scoring, if she wants to know, McCormack knows that she's ahead going into this fifth and final round. And I wonder how that, if in any way, informs her decision-making in this final round.
I don't think McCormack is the type of athlete that will take the foot off the gas pedal even if she knows she's up.
She was a plus 360 underdog coming into this fight. She's 3 minutes away from becoming a champion.
And the fact that she was dropped twice in that first round, and she was so close to being put away and to rally and come back and have the fight that she has with a broken nose, with her eyes looking like they're almost shut. So incredibly impressive right now.
We're halfway through round number five.
I think one of the reasons she's not going to let up on the gas pedal is because she wants to make Tina Black pay for putting her down in the first round. Like, she's just bulldog mentality.
Well, sometimes in life, too, you just got to hang in there, right? Until things turn in the other direction. And she certainly did that in round number one.
You can see Machado was trying to get bicep control and then head control, disengage in a strike.
Back against the cage.
You know what? I'm not going to disrespect that takedown anymore or say I want anything else in front of it because she
has worked every single time.
That entry has worked for her.
Trying to get Machado back to the ground.
Machado trying to whizzer, but McCormack doing a really good job of riding that out, staying on control, but she's going to watch out for the armbar.
Got to be careful here, of course.
Smart positioning from Machado. Now she's looking to extend and lengthen. Danni McCormack, the way to defend this is to stay as tight as she has stayed this whole fight. Elbow is free. Oh, she put her elbow back in. I get it on the other side there. Oh, it's extended. I think the elbow's free again. Elbow's out again.
And Machado looks spent as she's laying on the ground.
And that's the thing is with those Hail Mary submissions, you got to put them on hard and fat. You got to explode.
Yeah. Because if you aren't able to capitalize, they leave you in a very bad position on your back where you don't want to be.
No.
To end out the round.
The Irish fans are now in full voice here as we're coming down the stretch. I see Shauna Bannon in the crowd cheering on her Irish countrywoman. Danni McCormack, 30 seconds left.
Oh. Nice trip there attempt, control from Machado, trying to control the ankle with her own foot. She's still looking for hooks, but she's not There's no urgency. There needs to be urgency. She needs to get up and get a finish now.
And she's just about out of time as we are to the final bell of the championship fight.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, after five exciting rounds of action, we go to the judges' scorecards, and here are the totals. Mark Sanchez and Joseph Mason have it 49-46. Joe Coca, 48-47. All for your winner by unanimous decision. And new Invicta FC strawweight champion of the world, Danni Mad Mac McCormack!